Mama Glenn, you got my back. Watch this. Why is it when stuff happens in our life, we get mad at God, we give up on God, we give up on church, we give up on the ministry, and what we need the most, we run from? Being in the club and doing all we was doing is what we needed to do, but that's what helped lead us to God. So now we've gotten with God, and we got our issues, we got our hang-ups, and now we're trying to get to a better place in life. But what we need the most when we're in trying situations, we run from. When you're hungry, you run to the refrigerator because it has food in there for you to eat, right? So when you're going through what you're going through in life, why do we run from God, run from the church, run from ministry, but yet we go through all the hell we go through and want to know why we can't get from A to Z and still stuck on B? I'm just being real today. Don't get mad at your boy today. Don't rush the stage because I can fight. But I just want you to understand something today. We got to get to a place in our life where we learn how to move and get the blame out the way. Get out the way. Get me out the way. I know you want, you don't, please don't say it out loud. You know we taping, but you know what I'm trying to say. You get to a place where you just need to move yourself and get out the way. Somebody give God a get out the way praise right now in the club. Some of us got to learn how to get out the way. Tell yourself one more again. Move, get out the way. Now watch this. Our scripture shows us something powerful. Many of you know this particular story in the Bible. Moses sent out 12 spies. He sent one spy from every tribe. He sent them out to go check out the promised land. He had them go check out the land of Canaan. Moses sent the spies out, see what it looks like. When the spies came back, Brother Porter and Sister Porter, y'all just got married. And when the spies came back from looking at the land, 10 other spies came back with a woe is me. They came back with a negative report. They came back with the land is filled with milk and honey, but it's giants over there. It's fortified city. It's all kind of people over there. It's too many of them. The army is too big. They got too many weapons. All we dealing with is a 38. They got Uzis and Glocks and all kind of stuff. We ain't got the right number of weapons. We ain't got the right number of people. The land is rich. It's flowing with milk and honey, but it's just too big. Big for us. Then you had two brothers by the name of Joshua and Caleb. Joshua and Caleb, they turned around, they listened to the other 10 spies give the message to the people, and the Bible says, this is Bishop's version, the Bible says, Caleb said, shut up everybody, the land that I saw is flowing with milk and honey. The land that I saw is able to conquer, be conquered. The land that I saw is for us. The land that I saw, God said is ours. And we can go over there. Yeah, it's more of them than it is of us. But we got one advantage over our enemies. We got G-O-D on our side. And as long as God is with us, can't nothing be against us. So Caleb told the people, shut up murmuring, shut up complaining, shut up bickering, shut up being fearful, shut up being defeated, and let's get ready and go possess the land, possess the territory that's ours. Despite of everybody and everything that they said around Caleb, despite of all the naysayers, despite of all the situations, despite of all the circumstances, Caleb and Joshua didn't allow them to influence their way of thinking, and they stayed focused on the prize. Now watch this. They stayed focused on the prize. So Caleb simply just told everybody around him to move and get out my way, get out my way, get out my way, because I'm going to possess and take over what's mine. Many of us want so much more out of life than what we're currently experiencing. And it's time to tell some things in our lives to simply move and get out the way. The Bible says to the terror, I have the ability to speak anything in the name of Jesus, and what I speak in the name of Jesus and speaking it in faith, it has to manifest itself. It has to happen for me. Now, don't get twisted and just start speaking some stuff and you ain't got no faith, or what you speak don't happen in the next 15, 20 seconds. This is life. This is not a 30-minute television show that everything starts out bad at 5:15 and by 5:25, everything is rolling good, and 5:29, where the Brady Bunch, Marsha's big nose got hit with the football, is going down in the credits roll. No, this is the real thing called life. Well, sometimes some things take a while before it manifests. Some things you speak right now, you may not see later on, but I'm not going to lose faith as I'm waiting for what I'm asking God for to manifest itself. So now I got to get to a place in my life where I learn to tell my situations and learn to tell some things to move and get out the way. Oh, some of you ain't got it yet. Turn to the book of Mark when you get some time. Not right now, but the book of Mark simply tells us that I can go to my mountain, Sister Banks, and I can look at my mountain. My mountain is my issue. My mountain, Sister Payne, is my problem. My mountain is my situation. It's my circumstances. It's my issues. It's my trauma. It's all my stuff I'm going through. And the Bible says, Sister Glenn, that I can speak to my mountain, and my mountain has to be, not might be, Sister Tanya, but it has to be, not could be, Elder Calvin, but it has to be removed. So if I got this mountain moving kind of faith, the Bible says I have. Watch this. And if I'm made in the image and the likeness of God, Brother Lewis, and Deacon Womble, if God created the heaven and he created the earth by speaking it, and then if he spoke it, and then I made it his image and likeness, thank you, and I speak it, then I should be able to do the same thing that my daddy does because I'm made just like him. And he says if I speak to the mountain will be removed. So now I'm here to tell somebody as we get ready to go home, I'm getting ready to tell some stuff in my life to move and get out the way. I'm getting ready to be like Caleb and tell some situations, you can't be attached to me no more. You can't be around me no more. You can't have my joy no more. You can't have my peace no more. You can't have my hope no more. I'm telling some situations tonight, move and get out the way. Somebody ought to scream to God right now. So now watch this. Move. Get out the way. Here's some stuff that got to go. I'm tired of living in fear. Scared that it ain't gonna work.